ऑनरेबल रक्षा मंत्री श्री राजनाथ सिंह, श्री अजीत डोवल नेशनल सिक्योरिटी एडवाइजर, जनरल रावत चेयरमैन COSC एंड चीफ ऑफ आर्मी स्टाफ, एचीफ मार्शल भदूरिया चीफ ऑफ एयर स्टाफ, डॉक्टर रेड्डी सेक्रेटरी DDR&D एंड चेयरमैन DRDO, डॉक्टर चित्रा राजगोपाल डिग्निटरीज ऑफ द डेस, फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम द मीडिया, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड थैंक यू फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी हियर टुडे. At the outset, I also wish, on behalf of the entire Indian Navy, wish to acknowledge all the support that we have got from the DRDO over the years. DRDO and the Indian Navy have got together and have had many success stories. And all these success stories are a result or born out of close cooperation and a long relationship together. We have the Hamsa series of sonars, which are a standard fit on our ships. We got the Varunastra, the heavyweight torpedo, which is going to again become a standard heavyweight torpedo on our ships. The Marich, the decoys. The Ushus, which is now the sonars of choice for our submarines. The Tal torpedo, lightweight torpedo. The Vesi, along with DRDO, that has done a lot of work on networking, which is one of the niche areas that we need to get into at the Navy. The Arnav gaming software. The software-defined radios, which are going to be the future of our communications between the ship, submarine, aircraft. And also we've had some success stories in joint development like the BrahMos surface-to-surface missile and, of course, the MRSAM. There are, as we speak, there are 98 ongoing projects with the DRDO. And I know for sure that 19 mission mode projects are doing extremely well. So I want to compliment DRDO for that. And also accept the fact that DRDO is extremely important to the Navy to maintain this technological edge, which is so crucial to naval warfare. When we speak of warfare, actually warfare and technology are synonymous. And warfare is changing at a rapid pace because it's being driven by technology. So therefore, it is very necessary for us to have a technologically up-to-date force. And here I want to contextualize the DRDO mission statement with this aspect of having a technologically updated force. And I want to quote the mission statement of DRDO. I quote, "It is to provide defense services decisive edge by equipping them with internationally competitive systems and solutions," unquote. In pursuit of this mission statement, I think there are two key determinants, which I call the two T's. One is time, because that isn't of essence in any military development project. If you can incubate and execute a particular technology, only then will you be able to harness this contemporary technologies, which are themselves galloping ahead. So time is of great essence. And second, of course, is technology. And here I would like to quote our Honorable Raksha Mantri. He had said this in a couple of seminars earlier, and I want to quote, "When nations go to war, the nation with better technology will win," unquote. So for us in the Navy, maintaining the right technological mix is very crucial. To my mind, ideally, the Navy must have a few percent, maybe 15-20% of slightly vintage, of vintage systems, but the bulk of the systems have to be contemporary. And then another small percentage would comprise, you know, cutting-edge technology which is being incubated or which is being imbibed into the service. And this ratio, to my mind, is ideal to ensure that the change management of technology is there as we move along in this at this rapid pace of technology. Here again, the DRDO has an important role in helping us in the Navy to get the right mix of force levels or technology levels. As we look into the future, and I'm sure the other chiefs also agree with me, that we aim to make the forces self-reliant forces and which are technologically empowered. And for this, we have to leapfrog technology. So I have the three recommendations on this count. The first is that the impetus of the services and DRDO have to be on niche technologies. I have given a list of niche technologies that the Navy wishes to have in future. And my recommendation is that the DRDO focus its efforts, energies, and funding on these niche technologies. I think import substitution is best left to private industry, which is maturing very fast and which has matured substantially. The second point I have is that we must take a closer look at, we have done that, and we must take a closer look at models such as DARPA in the US. We are a focused team with adequate funding, given the right direction, and given strict timelines, can come up with path-breaking innovations for defense. And lastly, the third point of recommendation that I have is that India is an emerging technological hub, and we need to encourage small-time innovators. Some of them, you'll be surprised to know, are servicing foreign navies, and they haven't been caught by us. So DRDO, I feel, can support and encourage them. There are two verticals. One is the DRDO vertical, which has got intellectual capital, got institutional strength, financial capacity, and production capability. And on the other hand, you have the second vertical, which is the innovators, who have the ideas, speed, and agility to meet timelines. If we can harness both of them, we can have a winning combination. So, ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, on our part, the Indian Navy is fully committed to indigenization and self-reliance. We are proud of what we have achieved in collaboration with DRDO. Today, in the sensor domain, we have got substantial capability, not too far behind contemporary technology. In basic weapon systems, we have made good progress. But it is in the state-of-art weapon systems and ordnance that is still work in progress. So I would request the DRDO to focus on this last aspect. Also, we are very lucky that the government of the day is fully seized of making the Make in India initiative and supporting it to the hilt. So it's a golden opportunity which we cannot miss. And I would request that both of us and the DRDO seize this opportunity to give the country a potent navy that can deliver the punch in a future conflict. Thank you. Jai Hind.